All right, hello everybody. Welcome to the stream this evening. My name is David. I go by Unreal Nighthawk on Twitch. So if you're from Twitch, I know we have some friends in the chat right now that are coming from Twitch, then you probably know me as Unreal or Unreal Nighthawk, but it is a pleasure to see you here tonight. Tonight, I am going to be doing a first look at a game that I discovered this week called Mech Engineer. This is a game that is going to be difficult. It is known for having a rather steep learning curve, which means we're going to have to learn a little bit as we go. But I think it's going to be a lot of fun because of the type of games that I like, and also because I really enjoy teaching people. I really enjoy the education piece of it. So I think that there could be something fun and really satisfying for me to add to this and to really help out the small developer find some, maybe some fans, maybe some super fans here. So tonight, like I said, we're playing Mech Engineer. We're going to get started. I have not played the game before. I just loaded it up. You can see it on the screen here. Very simplistic. It is a sort of pixel art game, you know, sort of reminiscent of something you would have seen on maybe like a DOS game from the 90s or something like that. It is a strategy game, sort of akin to the original XCOM, sort of, and difficult in that it doesn't explain how every game mechanic works. You definitely have to try it out for yourself, see what gets you killed ultimately, and determine what you would do differently next time. So let me start just by reading a description of the game. So Mech Engineer is a dark sci-fi mech assembling manager with an auto-battling mechanic against a mutating alien bioweapon. We control a walking city, a former space mining station that is on its last leg and starting to fall apart. We must look for resources to restore the station, try to keep pilot morale up, and find the unique parts that we need to fly away from Earth. Because that's right, this is the lost cause. We are all that's left of humanity, and our best hope at this point is just to run away. The enemy wants to destroy the remnants of humanity and is constantly looking for us, while also at the same time changing the climate of the planet. It is constantly being transformed, terraformed, to be more hospitable for the aliens who are coming in to take over. So we have an entire industrial complex of production, research, and customization for our mechs, and frankly, they're the only things that's going to be keeping us alive. We are starting with some, relatively simple mining mechs, but as we go, we'll research new chassis, new weapons, new things like that to upgrade, to make ourselves have a little bit more bite, and to hopefully be a little bit more survivable. In order not to lose mechs or pilots, for each type of terrain or enemy, we need to select the parameters of the reactor, cross-country ability, heat transfer, and last but not least, our weapon systems. So again, from what I've seen so far, I've watched Splattercat play this on YouTube. I've read all the comments there. I've read comments over on the Steam page and things like that. And from what I've seen so far, if you're the kind of person who likes to nerd out and really min-max all the variables, then and if you like to do that amid a number of changing conditions over time, then this might be a game that's really good for you. We are gonna die, guaranteed. But in dying and going through that process, we're gonna learn how the game works in the heat of battle, and we're going to try again, hopefully doing a little bit better. And in that way, the game seems a little bit like a roguelike to me. Even though it's not really labeled as a roguelike, I'm calling it a roguelike because I think, you know, it has permadeath, it has the replayability of like, let's do it again, let's do it again, let's try a different format and try it again. It feels very roguelike to me. Another thing that I should say right here at the beginning is that I'm running the beta 30.5, which was just released today. It is hopefully including a lot of bug fixes, and a full update with lots of these things will be rolled out next week for everyone else. Now, one thing I really love about this, I think I mentioned earlier, this is an early access game, but the developer is extremely active. We're seeing, you know, I was looking at the history earlier, we're getting about one update per week or so. So he is actively going in and adding new functionality, swapping out graphics, responding to the feedback that we've been seeing in comments and on Steam and all that stuff. And like I said, rolling out updates, doing things about it. It was planned to originally launch this month, and it seems like maybe it's not going to happen because there's still more bugs being reported, and we'll probably hit a couple ourselves as we go through it. So it is still being worked on, but it's a great time to go check it out. If you would like more information, check out the description down below in the video. I have links to the Steam page as well as links to the game developers and the Discord for this game. So if you want to go check that out, that is a great place to go and get some help. Oh, another thing is I will be streaming at least two more Let's Plays or tutorials over the coming weeks. So please do leave a comment below, or in this case, if you're watching live in the chat, and let me know what you think of the game. And especially if there's anything you'd like to see in a future video. If you have questions, if something's confusing, just let me know. I love to help people, and I'd be happy to address that in a future stream. And then, of course, if you like this content, don't forget to subscribe. I have already scheduled another stream for a week from today at the same time, so it'll be, so far it's looking like every Friday. So be sure to check back for the next stream next week. All right, well, without further ado, let's go ahead and jump into the game because I've been talking too much already, I think. But I'm kind of okay with that. I think it's okay to establish some baseline expectations of what we're about to get into. And if you haven't heard of the game before, hopefully that's useful context. I see Cater in the stream right now. Sounds like she maybe hasn't heard of it before and says it sounds pretty interesting. Cool, I think so too. So very simplistic interface. Like I said, it's sort of like got that like pixel art, sort of like 90s retro game feel to it. And I found this a little bit confusing off the bat, but in order to get started, we actually have to choose a save slot that we want to load into. Now, I haven't played it before. All of them are empty at the moment. Once you load into a save slot or create a game, it will put in the timestamp in there to show you which one you can pick from. But this is a permadeath thing, sort of like a always on Iron Man, which means there is no save scumming. You're not going to save, and then if it doesn't go your way, reload and try the battle again. No, like it's Iron Man. When you die, and that's it. So to get started, you just click on the button there. All right, there is a lot of text describing the scenario, kind of where things are. How this came to be the way that it is. I'd say it's important to kind of jump in and kind of get a high level. Splattercat gave a description that I think was probably adequate, although I like to maybe dig a little bit deeper. So I'm going to read it. I'm going to read it. The year is 2198, except I'm not going to use that voice for the whole time because I can't keep it up. The year is 2198, the main asteroid belt of the solar system. At the Plato Space Research Station, an experiment is underway to create a long-term traversable wormhole in a dodecahedron filled with an antimatter. The experiment is broadcasting to the entire system. Inside of the 12-kilometer cage, during the experiment, for a moment, is created a wormhole. In its place, a large alien spaceship appears, similar to a sea, calm with two rings in it, around it. The ship, with acceleration, breaks through the structures and, after a short pause, starts an attack with missiles. AI at the production spaceship Vorderod, Yug, receives an order to evacuate people from distant lines to Earth. Vorderod Yug is a mining facility with human-based artificial intelligence, which is using mechs to mine and deliver ore. The clam catching up the Vorderod Yug near the Earth and launches a rocket. The facility is heavily hit and settles to the bottom of the Atlantic Ocean. Soon, an orbital bombardment of the main cities of the planet begins, and then an invasion. AI decides to wade out underwater and rebuild the ship into a walking city. The artificial intelligence of the station will have to arm the minor mechs to fight the invaders and find necessary parts in order to fly away from Earth. All right, so the important things to take away from this: we are a sort of like human-driven AI that is running this station, responsible for defending the station, the people on it, getting them off planet to kind of like escape from everything that's going on, kind of like I explained earlier. And we are trying to do our best to protect ourselves with the leftover mining mechs that we have. We are landlocked at this point. We are kind of up on the land, and like it says, a walking sort of station. And it's gonna get rough. We're gonna be struggling for a little while. Hey, Shayna Gray, welcome to the stream. All right, so I have the tutorial enabled. This is my first play. I've not gotten any further than this. I just kind of loaded it up to make sure that it would work. And so I'm gonna jump in and start figuring out how to use it. It says you have four main menus available: engineering, components, research, hangar. Engineering is used for assembly, components used for creating new components, research for gaining access to creating new components, hangar is for strategic planning and city construction. To start assembling the mech, go to the reactor tab and drag it to the bottom center of the screen onto the construction table. Okay. Let's go ahead and X out of that. We do have some sounds and things happening in the background. It's unclear to me what exactly. Like, I can hear it. It looks like it's coming through on the stream okay. Let me know if the music is a little bit too loud and I'll make an adjustment. But yeah, so we have these tabs up here. There is also a help section. I intend to read through the help later. I didn't want to spoil anything by reading all of the tutorial, all of the help manual later. Or I didn't want to read it in advance because I didn't want to spoil anything. I want this to be an authentic first look at the game. And I will read this next time. And as we, I will read through all of this. And then by the time we have the Let's Play a week from today, I will hopefully be a little bit more prepared and able to share more of what I learned through going through this tutorial. And it really does sort of feel like that, you know, I don't know, again, I might be showing my age a little bit, but like playing video games in the 90s when you had to, you'd go and buy the games at the store, you'd come with the CD or, you know, whatever, and you'd have that like book, you'd have that like really thick book in the case that you'd read through, and that would like have all the details for everything you need to know about the game. I appreciate that we have that book in a digital format here, though I do wonder if it could be made available. Like as a wiki. I think I saw some people asking about a wiki. Something that we could read in advance or like before we buy the game, just to give us some ideas of what this game is about and how to get into it, because I would really love to see that stuff early. It looks like we have some mechs here. They are named. There's Steel, Shadow, Mr. Green. Looks like we have two Mr. Greens and two Steels. Okay. I think it said we can drag that into the middle. Fill the blinking slots with the appropriate modules. The reactor must be activated. Change the individual parameters of the mech in the extra menu. Send the mech to the hangar. Okay. I think I got it. So it wants us to go to the reactors first. So I think we need to drag the reactor into the center. Oh, right. So I currently have a mech up here, like loaded up, which means it is not gonna let me drag it to the center yet. So, what if I. How do I get the mech back over here? I don't know. What if I go just to a different section of the map? Yep, it gave me that again. It still has this loaded up this time. I have no idea what these numbers are for. That scares me a little bit. Like, I have no idea what those numbers are doing exactly. Now, I did warn you all at the beginning, this is a game that is going to have a steep learning curve. Not very much is explained. And so, oh, maybe this was what I wanted. Nope, engine is not running. Can I test it? I think this is a screenshot here at the top. So, how do I replace what I'm looking at in the center with the reactor? Yep, popped up again. How do I get rid of this mech that's loaded up here? I can't drag it back. Right-clicking on it has canceled things in a previous menu, but it looks like that's not doing it for me. I cannot click this button. It gets angry at me if I do that. I don't know. And this is definitely what I want to do. But I don't know how to switch to... So what it was saying is I need to customize my reactor first before I can actually do anything in the game. Before I can load up my mech and kind of get it up and running, I need to configure all the details for my reactor first. Kay says, try clicking and dragging the mech picture in the bottom screen to take it to the left. Ah, down here. Ah, that did it. Thank you. Thank you, Kay. That was great. Okay, so I'll drag you to the middle now. Fill the blinking slots with the appropriate modules, add additional components, start the reactor, and test it. Only an activated reactor can be placed in the mech. That makes sense. Here is our reactor. It's starting with these red flashing components over here, which has to do with what we see on the right side. It looks like my face is blocking that a little bit. One second. Let me move my... Oh, that's not the right one. Let me move my camera down. Ooh. So that it is easier to see. Cool. Okay, so we have a bunch of these. It looks like some sort of stats on the side here. 10s, and the bottom one is a 15. This is piston. There's also injector, and it's similar to the other one. There's a bunch of 4s and now a 5. So the bottom one appears to be best, if I'm reading the numbers, if I'm intuiting that correctly. And then aux. I assume these are the things that we'll put in this side over here. External cooling, internal cooling, system multiplier. Reduces heat from outside, reduces heat from inside. Oh. Okay. Let's start with the piston. I think I'm going to load up the first one with the beefiest one we have. 15. And then with the injector. Sure. Let's do the beefiest one for that too. Okay. And now we want to load up the aux. External cooling, inner cooling, system multiplier. It's so unclear what this one actually does. System multiplier minus reduces the heat from outside, or no, plus reduces the heat from outside, minus reduces the heat from inside. I don't know. I am just going to load up some of these. And there are numbers, it looks like, that change based on... Looks like based on where they are loaded up. Looks like it goes 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 0.7 and 40. 0.7. 0.4 and 20. Okay, I wonder if that's something that changes based on... Yeah, it looks like based on the one that's next to it, it will determine... Oh, no, that one's different too. Huh. No idea. Let's just do 3 and 3. I have no idea what it's for exactly. And it doesn't seem like we're like losing on anything by doing this. Now I did see that there is another piece to this, which is engineers. Like we have a number of engineers up here, and whenever we make changes to certain things, there will be a cost to the number of engineers. Like they're getting assigned to the project, and they work on their project until it's done. I think frequently just the day. Then we recover them at the end of the day. But there might be some sort of a cost for doing this for them. Like assigning more engineers to actually assemble the reactors, potentially. No clue. .11, 1.20... Yeah, I have no idea what these numbers mean, but that's okay. I think it will become clear later. So once we've loaded all this up, we can see the reactor temp right there. I don't know if these buttons actually do anything here. Doesn't look like it. So let's go ahead and click this test button. Does not look like the test button is working. Maybe ignite? Maybe the big exclamation point? Ooh, okay, so it's got that, like, button flap, like, warning thing. So let's load her up. Okay, reactor temp is rising. We do have these numbers here that are changing. 0.6. It is barely... No, I think it's staying about where it is. Okay. That seems fine to me. Again, not at all sure what I should be looking for, but I think that's good. So, I think that means I can load this back over here. Yep, and oh, and there's some stats now, so we can see the weight, the output, the max temp, and cooling. Let's go ahead and do that for the other reactors, so we have a full complement of mechs to work with. So, I'll do the same thing, because I still have no idea what is going on. I will load up the external cooling and the inner cooling. I'm assuming these are things that will change based on environmental factors later, like in a very cold or a very hot climate. Maybe we'll have to include more external cooling. If we have weapons that are particularly heat sensitive, maybe we have to do more internal cooling. I have no idea. It's a guess. All right, this one is loaded up, and it looks like so far, at least, these stats that are down here in the bottom are essentially the same, and the reactor temp is also pretty much the same, even though technically our stats were a little bit different. So let's look at these side by side and see what it says. All right, so there is a little bit difference in the output, 42 versus 53, and the max temp is also a little bit better in the one with the lower output. So, I don't know. This is going to be a lot of exploration. All right, I'm going to tell this not to show this anymore. I'm a little bit concerned that it's going to shut off all of the tutorial for, like, the entire game, but I'm going to be doing this at least one more time after this, so I'm just disabling it. We're going to load up the piston and the injector. And now let's load up the aux. And I'm curious now, I'm going to do it in a different format. I'm going to do three along the side, and then I'll do three along the other side, because I think the arrangement of these things actually makes a difference. It's unclear how all of these things are connected, but this is part of that min-max part. If you experiment enough, you can figure out exactly where it all goes. Yep, numbers all look the same as before, so let's pop you back over there. You know, my output is actually better on these two versus the first one I did, which seemed to have better numbers. I would assume the output is like power output, because it's a reactor that we're building. And I would have expected that with the better numbers that we had for the injector and piston, that we would have seen better numbers in our output, but maybe that's not how it works. It is very likely that I'm misunderstanding something. Does not look like that the arrangement of the aux systems made a difference in this case. So I will try a completely different pattern and see if that changes anything else. Right, and we got to throw in the injector, and we got to throw in the piston. Let's ignite. Kay says, yeah, try swapping the advanced piston for the basic one. Okay. I mean, I assume that it would be the same as just looking at a full lineup, like between one that is using the advanced versus the basic. Yep, this one looks to be about the same as all the other ones. And then, yeah, okay, so we have the one that's 42, which is the one that used the advanced things. What if I stop? So this is another thing. We can't change aspects of the reactor while it's running. It's logical, right? So we got to turn it off before we can make a change to the piston or anything. So I'm swapping it out with a different one. Again, I'm assuming that the number is like bigger is better, but I have no idea if that's true in this case. It was a 43. Let's load it up and try again. Oh, output is 61 now. That is much better. Interesting. Our max temp is a lot lower though. So apparently some combo of basic injector plus advanced, or no, basic piston plus advanced injector made that difference. So right now it's 61 energy output. Yeah, here's 53. If I put both of the higher numbers in, it drops to a 42 of energy output. What if I put in a different injector but kept the advanced piston? 41, so it got even worse. Interesting. Okay. Well, we're looking at the min-max. I don't think it matters at this point in the game, but let's try to make our output even better by doing that. Oh, I didn't start it. We must start the reactor before we can put it into our mech. Thank you for that suggestion, Kay. I appreciate it. All right. Now let's take and drop it back in the queue. All right, so that is our reactors. All of them have been configured and enabled, tested. They're all ready to go. Next, let's take a look at the weapon systems. So we have all of these here in our inventory. From looking at other people, it looks like we could probably do about one of each. Doesn't mean it's the right format necessarily, especially not for every scenario, but we could do one weapon, one missile system, one Gatlin, if we're able to manage the weight correctly. Again, I have no idea if that is a thing or not. Kay says the max temp is much higher, which means it'll run longer under load and in hotter environments. Oh, I see. Okay. So looking back at the reactors. Yeah, the max temp was like 290 with the advanced of both of those. And it went from 226 to 215 with the sort of like hybrid model that I was trying out. So, yeah, in certain circumstances, that might make a big difference. I have no idea how big of a difference it makes for us now. All right, so here is our missiles. Distribute the free points between the characteristics of the weapons. Save the result if necessary. Add a unique modification. Check the work result on the screen. All right, so again, this is all part of like the meat and potatoes of what you're doing in this game is customizing your mech and all of the systems to be the best system possible for the scenario that you're going to be running through, the mission and all of that fun stuff. As I said earlier, the mission for the most part is an auto battler. You'll have little control over what they're actually doing. And so this is what the game is all about from what I've seen so far. Here's our missiles here in the middle. We do have these points that you can see on the sort of left side right there. And there's all these little ticks that we can do to customize exactly which factors are most important to us. Does not look like I can click on these, but I'm assuming these matched with the sliders here. So it's like number of bullets, number of missiles maybe fired in the first one. Looks like this one is weight, so I'm guessing with a negative. So you could do like the more notches you have in here, the reduced weight that you get with this. The other one probably accuracy. The next one I'm guessing. Oh, actually, it probably is similar to these, but in a different order, oddly. Oh no, I bet this is the first one up here. Number of projectiles, and then weight, energy, damage, and armor penetration. Okay. It's probably that final one right there. Hello! The developer is here. Hello, Kyber Cracker. Let me know if I said that correctly. I did pick the beta branch, I believe. I'm pretty sure that I got that right. Thank you for your help. I mentioned at the very beginning of the stream, but we have information in the doobly-doo in the description of the video, which includes a link to the game over on Steam, as well as the contact info or the Twitter details of the developers, including Kyber Krecker here. And it includes a link to the Discord. So if you want to get more help and share things and share bug reports and whatnot, go ahead and go check out the Discord for the game directly. Hey, it's okay, Cater. Don't worry about it. Enjoy your golfing. All right, so we are customizing these missiles now. And it looks like I think these are the buffs, the components that we can do to change exactly how the missiles work. Small rapid-firing rocket system with self-guiding missiles. Okay, so let's take a look at what these numbers actually do for these stats. I have no idea how, like, intense, like, how much damage they actually do. It looks like the penetration changes quite a bit as you dial in the actual toggle here. That is definitely weight. That is definitely the number of shots being shot. And accuracy. So accuracy is not tracked over there, of course. Like, that would be a little silly, perhaps. But I think that's what we can track up here in this main testing display. So if we toggle this on, we will simulate firing our missiles at a target. Looks like we can do moving target, stationary target, and then one that tests penetration, if I remember correctly. So we can see, like, if things will go through. So I don't know, and we can check right here what the accuracy amount is right now. So it's about 60%, which I don't know. I don't know how that feels for a missile. It might be good. Potential damage, 118, 110, 112. Armor damage, quite a bit. I have no idea. And again, this is one of those areas where you kind of have to try something, go with it, make changes over time, and then see exactly what happens with that. Potential damage went up when I increased the number of shots being fired. Or maybe it's my imagination. No, I don't think so. I think it actually did go up. Even so, I think I'm thinking of with a missile system like this, firing fewer is fine as long as they hit really hard. So I think minimizing the number of shots fired, increasing the accuracy so that we're certain that it is going to hit. So it's up to 95%. That is incredible, actually. Maybe too much at that point. 90% might be good enough. And then put everything else into damage. I mean, technically, if we're looking at just the stats here, the potential damage is quite a bit less like this. I wonder how ammo factors into this. Because if I'm looking to maximize the potential damage, then potentially, what if I drop the damage all the way down, increase the capacity that we're sending out up? How does that change? It's higher by a fair amount. 132 versus what was like 90 or 100 or something before. Plus significantly higher armor damage too. So that's interesting. That changes my strategy. The fact that we're hitting 90% accuracy, or I guess like it's jumping around, but I wonder if I should play with that. I also might have to tweak this based on what the eventual weight ends up being, so I can make sure I can fit as many weapons as possible on the mech once that time comes. If I reduce the accuracy a little bit, in the interest of increasing the capacity that we're sending out, how does that change the numbers? 140, 240. Oh, 150, okay. So decreasing the number, the accuracy in favor of sending out more missiles does seem to be beneficial for potential damage. Okay, well, you know what? I'm going to keep it like this, I think. I will probably have to make more tweaks as we go, probably many, many more tweaks. But I think maybe this would be a good place to start. Kay says, you can click the little side slider to bring the target closer and further out. Try bringing the target closer to the weapon. Oh, I forgot about that. So this slider right here. So if I bring it closer, the accuracy goes down significantly. Oh. Okay, so the missiles would be good at range, but it looks like they're pretty terrible up close. At least with the numbers that I have set. How do I feel about that? I mean, the potential damage is still very high, though, which is confusing. It makes me think maybe I'm not reading this right. I'm not sure. Versus, let's say, really, really far out, as far as it will go out. Let's watch the accuracy increase. As it's having a chance to kind of like catch up and realign itself. Accuracy 100% now. And the potential damage, the armor damage is huge, but the potential damage is roughly the same as what it was before. Curious. Okay, well, like I said, I'm gonna leave it exactly how it is for now. I have no idea if this is a good plan or not, but that's the nature of the game, I think. So let's save this. I was seeing in the video from Splattercat that there's like this export-import way to like save your configuration. It would be really great if there was some sort of indicator of that. I do see the little tape reel here, which, knowing what it means, you know, implies like I could see it's like saving my work or something. But it'd be nice to have some sort of a confirmation that it actually happened. Like, there's no way for me to know what this does unless I just know. So I'm assuming this means save it, save the configuration. Let's load up another one. Yep, and let's go ahead and don't show this again, because I'm familiar with this already. And let's import. Yes, that worked. Let's go ahead and do the last one. Let's import. Okay, and then what configuration are not configuration, what are these called? These over here. Additional boost, bonus, component. Critical strikes, increased damage, less penetration. For a missile, increased damage would be good, of course. Let's keep reading. Shards after hit can deal damage behind the target. That sounds pretty decent, actually, for a missile. And it has, like, realistic story implications. There's a reason for this. It's blowing up, it's causing debris. I like that one. Let's keep reading. Create fireplace on hit. Less damage and penetration. How much less, though? Because that also sounds pretty good. Okay, watching potential damage is currently at 150 or so. If I pop you in, potential damage dropped a lot down to about 80. Armor damage also is significantly less. So, looks like there's no way to, like, undo. Like, I can't, like, unload this. I just have to probably go and find the empty one and load that in instead. Slowing enemies. Let's see how that changes these numbers. It's slightly higher, it looks like. So that would be less of a penalty to slow the enemies. But I'm hoping I can just kill them. I don't know how... again, this would probably play in more later. Creates many shots, less rate of fire. This seems... They counter each other. Like, creates many shots, less rate of fire. So our potential damage increased significantly. Oh, I see. Interesting. Huh. That is very interesting. And what about at range? I assume at range. Oh, yeah, wow. Most of them hit. I don't know. That seems very good. So far, this is the winner. I'm gonna come back to it though. Increased penetration, less accuracy. I think I'm not worried about that for a missile. Acceleration, higher initial speed. Let's try you and see what it does. Reduces my accuracy, which is expected. I don't think I care as much about this. Erase last debuff. Yep. Debuff? Should that be buff? Erase last debuff for free. Because I assume all of these are buffs, right? All these are things that we're doing to increase our weapon system. Critical strikes, increased damage, less penetration. Oh, that's the one I said I think I really like the idea of. But, man, I mean, if I like the idea of shooting out tons and tons of missiles. Let's see what this shard one looks like, if there's like a visual representation of that. Let's switch to stationary. Okay, I see little shards getting shot out. Not quite as many as I had thought there would be. Oh yeah, there we go. Now that they're actually hitting, it's shooting out quite a few more. I mean, that seems very promising too. What is our potential damage now? For, let's say 450, 500, something like that. Okay, says the little knob to the left of the slider will let you see how they work against a static target in groups. Ah, I see, yes. That would be good for, in this case, groups. What does taken damage mean? I didn't see that one incrementing earlier. Taken damage. Yeah, I'm not sure. Not sure. Okay, so this seems, again, really, really promising. Yeah, so, wow, potential damage for this one with three targets is a lot higher, which I guess is to be expected, right? With one stationary target, we're looking at around, just trying to establish a baseline now. So about 500 for 70, yeah, somewhere around 500 potentially with this one, with the shards. If we switch to the creates many shots, it is a lot less. Okay. Well, like I was saying before, I think narratively it makes sense to have the shards. So let's just go with the shards. That's easy. Yeah, let's do that. So I need to drop that in now to the other missiles as well. Blammo. There we go. Cool. And now we just have our Gatling guns. Let's load up a Gatling. All right. So, similar deal. We have to start with figuring out exactly how we want to put our points in. How do we want to assign these points? I mean, of course, lots of damage seems like it would be a good idea, but as we were seeing earlier, lots of damage didn't really result in lots of potential damage. So potentially spraying the field with lots and lots and lots of ammo, that could do better, especially knowing that there are going to be like swarms of aliens coming for us. I don't know if we need to change weight yet. I'll have to come back to that once we load it up in a mech. The, what's this one? Accuracy? How much do we care about accuracy? Probably a fair bit. But what if we didn't care about accuracy? What if we just shotgunned it? Our accuracy is 2% right now. At least at that range. Closer though. What does it look like a little bit closer? Accuracy should improve. Potential damage is pretty big. Accuracy has improved. What if, so we're looking at a potential damage of about 150, 160. If I drop my damage and increase the number of shots being fired, we are looking at less damage. Potentially. Slightly less damage. So what if I go slightly in the other direction then? Let's go down by 5 and put all of that into damage. Looks a little worse, I think. On the last weapon page, I think the damage is described. You mean like in the book, in the help book, or somewhere on here, in the book? Okay, yeah, I haven't read the book yet. I wanted this to be a as authentic of a first look at the game as possible, so I did not read the book, but I will be reading the book before my next Let's Play, which is scheduled for a week from today. So it'll be next Friday, 9 p.m. Central Time, or apparently 6 a.m. wherever you are. But yeah, I will be reading the book before then for sure. Yeah, I don't think this actually panned out for us. What if we dropped the damage to nothing and then increased our accuracy? That does appear to be resulting in better potential damage. Or maybe not. I thought it was at first, but not so much anymore. Yeah, I just don't know. I think what I'm gonna do is, I'll keep it like this. I want it to be slightly more accurate than it was before, but I just want to get as many bullets out there as possible, anticipating that they are going to be swarming us, and it's probably going to hit something. Let's see what little special things we can put. So it looks like the same ones. Slowing fire, fires many shots. What does that look like with this one? Ah, shotgun, yeah. I mean, again, if we're trying to stay on theme, I wonder if this, yeah, I was also curious about the ammo implications of this. Less rate of fire and accuracy. I don't know. I'm gonna go with it. It could be a very, very bad idea, but I am gonna go with it. Oh, let me, before I switch over there, let me export the configuration for this gun. Throw it over here, grab the next one, and import. We'll throw in the mod. Toss it away, toss in a new one. Throw in the stats, throw in the mod. I wonder if I can just drag in a new one. Yeah. Saves a step, which I appreciate. So I don't have to drag out the old one. I mean, for all I know, this could also be very, very expensive. Right? For all I know, like, this could be prohibitively expensive for us to build or configure, or who knows? I certainly do not. This is curious. My rate of fire. Yeah, less rate of fire and accuracy. Okay, I see. That makes sense why this meter dropped significantly when I did that. I will think about an ammo stat. Yeah, that would be helpful. If there are ammo implications, for picking one over the other, that would be good to know. Okay, last one. Cool. We have now weapon systems that are optimized for mechs that are shooting shotguns and firing missiles that will do a sort of spray. Hopefully that does enough splash damage across the board that that will paint them up real nice. All right, let's try mech. We need to fill the slots. The reactor must be activated, which we did. It's a check. Change the individual parameters of the mech in the extra menu. Send the mech out to the hangar. Okay. So we need to assemble the parts, and then once everything is assembled, then we need to send it off, which is the button right here, so that we can put it in the hangar and go out on a mission. So we need a cabin or cockpit. We'll throw it in. I wonder, it'd be a little weird, but I wonder if these could go in any other slot other than the intuitive one. I'm guessing not. It sort of looks like it goes there. So, yeah, probably just goes there. Motors. Are these all the same? They look to be all the same. Okay. So, I'll drag, it looks like these into these slots. And I was told, or maybe in the, yeah, you can hold shift to place them in like that. Hey, Rachel. Welcome to the stream. Right, and then aux. Increases the firing time, decreases reload time for the ammo module. Battery module increases energy in percent. I'm not sure what this word means, whether it's a typo or just vocabulary unfamiliar with, but increases energy in percent. Don't know. Evasion module. Evasion rating plus 25%, minus 3 max weight, so you can carry less and you get less armor. That is probably not something I'm going with. Let's throw in an engine. Since this is our first one, let's just throw in the awesome engine first. Or reactor, I should say, not the engine. Weapon systems. I think our weapon systems are all the same. I mean, like, our missiles are all the same, and then our guns are all the same. So we'll throw you in, and then we'll throw in our Gatling gun. It looks like our weight is under, which is great. Our energy is also looking swell. Reload 1.8. Passive armor 5, speed 0.98, 14 hit points, max outside temperature 136. I assume I'll need to look at that when I'm picking my mission to make sure that I'm not sending folks out into an area that they're going to totally boil alive in. Let's do ammo. Ammo modules, and let's watch that stat. Reload is 0.178, 0.176, so it does make a difference. All right, let's give that a try. What else can we do here? Oh, this is the amount of weight that each component is taking up. Unclear exactly how this plays into things, but I wonder if it's possible to like unbalance your mech if you have something exceptionally heavy in one side and not the other, or something. Or like if you put too much weight on top and not enough on the bottom, you become unsteady and like fall over or something. I don't know. What's the next one? In this menu, you can change the armor of the mech. Add active armor against missiles, add self-destruction systems, add a shield against energy attacks, and melee. Well, I think we definitely want armor. Blocks damage below value, higher damage reduces armor. Higher damage reduces armor. Oh, okay, I see. So it completely blocks the damage that goes below the value, and then anything that's above the value We'll just reduce the armor. That seems really good. Active armor. Spent on destroying missile. Okay, so the active armor will crumple. It will destroy itself whenever a missile hits you. So it'll keep the missile from damaging you, but it will in fact destroy our armor. I wonder how many missiles we have coming at us in the early game. There is a weight factor. It looks like we do have a fair bit of weight to play with, though. There's a self-destruction system. Undying mech will explode. That does not appear to use any weight or anything else that I can see. Okay, there's an energy shield, which does use energy. Probably a good idea, because we have plenty of energy. We have even more energy to work with than we do weight, so that seems especially good. Melee defense. That does use weight, but not much. It adds +2. This is another thing. I have no idea how much this matters, but if we're dealing with swarming bugs, having something we can have melee defense against or attack for, I think that makes sense. It looks like it uses 2 weight, so maybe it's worth trading some armor for some weight, or for some melee. Okay, so I added 4 of that. Maybe I'll add, like, 2 of the active, and then add as much just regular armor as I can. Okay, that puts me over. So maybe 12. Maybe 12 is where it's at. Hello, Louisa. Welcome. All right. So I think that's it for this one. What's the next one? Mech damage is sorted into 5 types. Use the left button to spend personnel on repairs. This will increase the damage to the overall structure. Use the right button to repair with metallite. Okay, so metallite is the resource we have up here, mineral that we're collecting. And damage the... you need to find a balance between spending engineers, metallite, and damage to the overall structure. Interesting. Okay. Alright. We don't have any damage right now, so I assume this is something we'll deal with a lot more later on. And this last one here, or next to last, we have in this menu, you can distribute the energy between the modules. Drag the plus or minus wires to one of the modules. The left wire will reduce the available power and the module's consumption. The right wire will do it vice versa. In this menu, you can distribute the energy between the modules. Drag the plus or minus wires to one of the modules. The left wire will reduce the available power and the module's consumption. The right wire will do it vice versa. Huh. I wonder how much I have to do with this right now. So here's the plus and minus. But... I've no idea what this means. Though, I think I will attempt to undo. Oops, I just did it twice. So then maybe the plus will undo that. Yeah, cool. I'm gonna leave it as it is. I don't quite understand this. Maybe this is something that I'll get better at if I read the book. But for now, I'm gonna ignore this section and wish for the best. Change the color of the brush using the 3 RGB values. The clamped shift may help. Adjust the size of the brush. Turn on symmetry as needed. Draw. Okay, so a paintbrush. These are the RGB values, I assume. And the size of the paintbrush. Looks like I can use my mouse wheel for this. Okay. That's interesting. So, Bright red. Okay. I mean, this could be something I could see being really cool later on. For now, I'm gonna use just this red on the front of the first one. I'm thinking maybe this one would be my captain, so maybe this is how I'll identify it. I don't know. We will see. Let's go ahead and, well, I'm gonna switch back to the regular view. If I can. What is that first one? This one here, maybe it's disabled. Maybe I don't have access to that one yet. Okay. I think I'm ready to send it over, so let's send it over. It did use engineers to kind of load it up and send it. So let's do it again. We'll throw in another mech. I think we're good to go ahead and turn off the tutorial for this section because I think we'll be okay. Let's toss in a reactor. And we'll do the ammo modules again. I'm just going to basically load it up the same because they're all essentially the same mech, at least the same weapons, the same stuff. Let's throw in a missile system and a Gatling. It looks like. Oh, you know what? So this is another area of customization, but I can control the weight of my weapons. That was one of those things that I'm putting points into. And of course, that means I can trade armor for higher quality weapons. If I'm willing to take less armor, that means my weapons can be heavier, which can result in a stronger punch or something. Oh, I need to press the save button in the paint menu. Oops. Okay. Well, I'm not going to worry about it this time. I'll try to keep that in mind next time, though. Okay, again, we're using engineers to send the mech over to the area where it needs to go. Let's do one more. I think this will be the fourth one. Maybe the third one. I will double check that. Cool. Let's load up a cockpit. We'll put in the motors. I think this is the third one. And then the aux, fill it full of ammo packs. And we'll send you over. Oh, you know what? I totally forgot to load these up with armor. Yep. What that means is I'm gonna have to send the other ones back if I want armor in them. And that could very well use engineers. That could be a problem. Yeah, that could be a big problem. We'll see. Did that save, though? Is there a save button on this screen? Looks like no. So let's send you. Okay, and let's do one more mech. And let's make sure this one has the correct armor. This is our last reactor, so I don't think we're going to be able to do anything more. We also don't have any more missile systems, so this will be a double Gatling shotgunner. Throw in the motors, which we don't have any more motors either. We'll throw in the cabin as well. We'll adjust the armor this time. We'll give it a melee just in case. We'll give it an energy shield as well. And we'll load up the active armor by two, just in case there's something with missiles out there. And then we'll throw in seven. Ooh, I can do more. Oh, because the missiles are heavier than the Gatlings. So I can put in a little bit more armor on this shotgunner. Not by much though, but a little bit. All right, cool. Let's send you over. And so now that we are done in the engineering wing, I bet I can go to the hangar wing. First of all, you need to determine the location of your station. The terrain all around you will greatly affect the complexity of the further game. Underwater, mechs without improvements are slowed, and hot maps can turn off an unprotected reactor in a second. Okay. I assume that all of these symbols mean something, and that I will learn what they mean in the book. As it is, I see what makes me think of water droplets. I can't make out what all of those symbols mean, but maybe that's a city? Possibly ice, like snow? Yeah, I don't know. Let's just go for like Europe. Let's take back Europe. We'll go like right here. Now you have access to three new menus: calendar with the city management, pilot menu, world map. Your task is to visit the cities and find the coordinates of special parts for the station. They will help you fly out of the Earth. Book is not that OP. Oops. Well, I will have to discover what they mean then. Oh, and one thing that Splattercat was explaining but didn't really get too much into is what these numbers mean. I think he said it's a little bit like a minesweeper. And so a 2 would imply that there's two enemy bases within, like touching, within a proximity of this space. The other ones imply that there's one somewhere within it. And I think he said that it could be even on top of that space. Now, I do also see these symbols, and I have no idea what they mean. I also see these bubbles here, and have no idea what they mean. Order new position, artillery. Select the card to confirm. The minimum recommended number of mechs for the battle is 4, but more advanced models can cope alone. During the battle, mechs perform the mission themselves. Movement orders are given by the captain of the squad on the first slot. You issue additional orders to move, focus fire, or support with artillery. The space bar can also pause the battle. Okay, good to know. To assess the situation. Okay, that makes sense. Although I don't know what that means. Armor 6 drags off with tentacles. Ooh, that's delightful. Where does it say how many mechs it recommends? Rams enemies. Probably not that one to start with. That sounds pretty dangerous. There's a map legend button under the map layer. Oh, okay. Over here. Cool. I'll check that in a second. And again, right click to go back if you deselect. Yeah, I don't know. Let's read some more stuff. The numbers on the map indicate the number of enemy bases or labyrinths within radius of one cell, including the current one. Your city. Attack tiles can only be selected a small radius around the city. The city can be moved. Selected cell. Enemy underground city labyrinth. Very dangerous. Contains many resources. Cannot be destroyed. Oh, okay. So the sword is a giant monster, very dangerous, able to destroy the city alone. Okay, stay away from those things then. At least now. Location of special parts. I assume I don't know any of those because I haven't explored any cities yet. Infested terrain, biological threat to mech pilots, stronger enemies, mega storm. The residual effect after the orbital bombardment of the enemy. It goes around the entire planet in a circle. Moving the city in a storm is impossible. Okay. That is good to know. The scan layer. Okay. Will this tell me what they are, though? Okay, that little icon right here mentions, like, it's the same as what we see here. But it does not exactly tell me what it means. I assume it's the terrain type. I don't want to move the city, so I won't worry about that. I think I'll put it back on this one. Okay. So I need to go to, oh, over here at the mechs. Right, I need to double check because some of these. Actually, it looks like only this one is the one that I forgot to give adequate armor. I don't know what I did. I just clicked on it. I could have accidentally dragged it just a little bit just now, but yeah, I'm not ready to read you. One second. I wonder if I don't know where it went. Let me go back to engineering. Is the mech here? Yes, the mech is here. Okay, so that probably used engineers, but by it being here, I can actually give it armor now. Good. Worth it, I think. Let's give it two active armor. And let's give it, I think it's seven. No, I can give it, yeah, seven passive armor. Okay, and let's go ahead and send that back over. I don't know if the engineer's number actually changed. I saw the little scan bar to imply that it did change, but I thought it was already a high 200. Station damage is 69%. Yep. Okay. So just as a quick little check-in, we are at we've been playing for how long have we been playing for? It looks like about an hour and 10 minutes or so, 12 minutes. And we haven't actually gotten into like a battle yet. But remember this, the name of the game is Mech Engineer. We are probably going to be spending the majority of our time in an interface like this. We are worrying about the logistics. We're worrying about the configuration of our base and our mechs and what resources we have. The combat system is important, obviously very important, but it's sort of like testing the results of all of our hard work. It's ensuring that we have picked a strategy that is sound and appropriate. So it's okay that we haven't gotten into the actual combat yet, because this is probably a lot of what we're going to be doing for the game. It looks like we have our pilots here. Oh man, what are all these status effects for this dude? He looks. Considering none. Well, okay, some of the other people have some status effects. But wow. This guy. Well, I guess a few of them actually have a rather significant number of these effects. But it makes me think I should probably take the ones that have those effects with me. Okay, let's consider a few things. Reaction time, or reaction, vitality, stress resistance, CBS test. Okay, so stress resistance, if I remember right, impacts how well they listen to you. How well they like obey orders and things like that, if I'm remembering it right. It's perks. Okay. Cool. Yeah, those things are perks. Got it. This guy and the others that have these perks have the little plus next to their heads, which probably means something. Wow. So this guy seems, Jennifer seems pretty good, but her reaction is terrible, and her vitality is also very poor. Which makes me think I need to put her in the hospital. Again, if I'm remembering right from what I saw in the videos, training will increase reaction and CBS test, whereas hospital will increase vitality and stress resistance, I think. So this guy has a pretty terrible reaction, very bad stress resistance also. Joe has pretty good and decent numbers, at least double digit numbers for everything, which is more than can be said for some of these folks. Oh man, Donald looks so promising until you see the two CBS test. Okay, so Gregory here seems pretty decent, I think. Honestly, I have no idea. Grasping at straws a little bit, but the numbers are really strong, especially stress resistance and vitality. It could use better reaction and CBS test, but it's better than some of the ones we've seen. So maybe I'll give him a roll. Do I put you? Oh. Oh, I see. These are buttons to sort based on reaction, vitality. Okay, got it. These are buttons to sort the list. Okay. Cool. Oh, looks like we have a bot. Let's see. I think I can mark that. Okay. And let's go ahead and hide the user so that no one else has to see that stuff. Okay. Cool. Okay. All the fun of streaming. Always someone there to take advantage of a live stream. Okay. Well, I think I have one person I'd like to put in. I'm not sure about the other people, though. And I might want to start by picking the people that I want to take with me and then putting the other ones in either training or the hospital. So, to do that, I think I have to go to the mission section. Before we do, though, before we go and kind of get the mission up and running, let me take a look at other things. So, we have component section, which is where we can build new equipment and things. We would like, I think I want four more engines because that would let us field another mech. This could be totally off base too. We could be very well like upgrading these in the future, but it seems practical and fairly inexpensive to build four more engines, so we'll do that. That would at least get us geared up to go. Looks like we are unable to build more. Oh, I need more engines or more another reactor too. So let's build one more reactor. I don't see a way to build more missiles, so I don't think we have like unlocked that weapon, I guess. And then there's components, right? You're right, which will be used to upgrade our base. So let's just max that out. I assume that this is all we can do is like these are the most that we can build at any one time. Hangar A and hangar B. Don't know. I wouldn't think of this as being a hangar so much as like a factory or something. But anyway, we'll do that. In the research section, here you can select several tasks of research depending on the available science staff. We currently have 160. Selection is possible by double-clicking or clicking on the bottom right. Right mouse button will display information with a small window. Oh. Just double-clicking on the right button will hide all windows. Okay. So we have very few options right now. Do we already have this one? Medlite, oh, that is really small. Medlite-based alloys restore part. Oh, it's just the same text as the side over there. Okay, so maybe I don't need to worry about right-clicking. I can just click on left-click. Yeah, okay, so since it says 0 and 0, I can't select it, I don't think. So I assume that means I already have it. What about this one? Engine parts. Move and connect equipment to create new ice parts. Okay. Powerful ice restore printing drawings of main engines. Okay, so possibly engines, pistons. This looks like a piston to me. Reinforced frame. Start repair of main mech hulls. I like the idea of having more mechs. So let's select that one. 2 days. We have the staff for it too. Do we have the staff to do a second one though? We have 60, this one takes 80, and that one takes 80, so no. I can zoom in and out with the scroll wheel. And looks like that's all we can do in the research section. Okay. So let's go to actually let's click on this. So this little banner here is our base. On the calendar, you can see the days when new models and research will be ready. The panel on the right shows the state of the characteristics of the city. The switch allows you to see the state of the city's districts and their impact on the characteristics of the city. To improve a district, you always need raw resources and components. Components can be ordered from the component menu. At 100% damage, the city will be destroyed. So we are at 69% damage, so we are not doing so hot. It would be great to be able to repair the city if we can. These little dots here are all things we can upgrade. Bottom connections, part of the city moving system. City movement is impossible if damaged. Wow, we have a ton of wounded humans too. 3,919 humans are injured or wounded. Okay. Upper connections, part of the city moving system. Okay. The disk, the foundation of the city, responsible for the operation of movement system and the state of the main supports. Okay. It looks like up here on top we have artillery gun, able to support mechs with fire in a mission on the surface or destroy a small th threat in the path of the city. Improvement will give more shots. I wonder if I have any shots right now. I'm guessing we don't have any shots because. And I'm guessing, I'm making some assumptions here, but it looks like maybe the first column is what we currently have, and the second column is what it will become. Maybe. -2% wounded humans if we have an artillery gun. I don't know if that makes sense, but maybe. Station damage will also go down by 1% by doing this. Station energy will increase by 1%. I mean, that all seems good. What's this one? Communication tower provides continuous communication with the mechs on a mission and also quickly broadcast messages throughout the city. Affects the time between orders. Okay. Control center. Controls the distribution of resources between districts and issues orders to executors. Okay. Hey, Buggy. Welcome to YouTube. It's great to see you here tonight. So let's see. Lots and lots and lots of things to click on and upgrade. If these numbers are any indication, it looks like there are roughly 66 things I can click on, potentially. Doesn't seem like there's that many here, but if this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I don't know. Maybe it is 7, 8, 9 in the center. I was also reading there's a relationship between the yellow bars and the blue bars, but what that is exactly, I don't quite have a grasp on. And I think maybe that will be, I'm hoping that will also be in the manual, something I can read up on later. In the meantime, I feel like we should do some sort of a if we have any ability to, it'd be great to do some upgrade. I wonder if it says two. I have no idea what the two means, though. I'm guessing this button will do the upgrade. It looks like to me, if this is a before and after, it looks like the stats don't actually change with this one. Upgrade the district to the next possible level. Air purification system. That would increase our life systems and decrease station damage and increase station energy. That seems all very positive. Residential area. Those are currently... Oh, so these... I'm trying to figure out what these symbols inside of the circles actually mean. Maybe they're not... Either they're not utilized. Like, the empty circles, like the completely empty circles, seem to all start with the 0%, which leads me to believe they're just not used. They're completely actually empty. The ones with the little, sort of yellow color in it does appear to have something going on there. The filled in sort of like grayed out ones, I have no idea why they're grayed out. Nope. Medical compartment. Yeah, it seems like upgrading the medical compartment, assuming this is a before and after in the columns there, I would expect that that would reduce the number of wounded humans if we upgraded this. Also, the relationship between this top circle and the bottom circle is confusing to me. Although it did seem to be pointing to certain ones. So you see, like, this one has a blue line pointing down to this particular section. Upgrade the district to the next possible level. Okay. So maybe these are districts. And maybe these are districts. Yeah, maybe just all of these things I'm clicking on are different districts of our base. Also unclear to me what the... I can see the resource icons for the different elements that we're collecting, but I don't know what they mean in reference to this. Maybe we have to pay that when we do the upgrade. No clue. Medical compartment, ammunition, factory. Let's see. Additional reactor. Emergency power generation. Contains its own medical compartment for treatment of radiation contamination. That's handy. This would increase station energy, which we appear to be low on, significantly. It will decrease station damage, which is great, and it will also decrease wounded humans. It's unclear to me if there are other like perks to unlocking these, and how this affects our pilots. Hydroponic farm. Good for the food supply, which is looks like not terrible. 75%. Upper factory. Does that connect to residential area? Hydroponics. Another residential area. Air purification system, which is connected over here to the disc. I wonder if the blue line implies that there is another upgrade required someplace else. Fourth generation fast reactor. Wasn't the one over here third generation? Fifth generation for this one. It uses 45 components, but this one is a fourth generation. It uses 45 components. Requires a lot of raw material, it says. Not so many more than what we had over here, though. Universal factory, residential foundry. Prison district, medical compartment, emergency bunker. Anabiosis units, equipped with anabiosis units. I don't know what that means. Well, I'm at the point where I feel like I kind of just need to pick something and move on. I'm inclined to pick something that would be good for our mechs, our pilots, our combat, but I would prefer to look at our stats here and pick something that is especially poor at the moment and try to improve that. Like, our life support is really bad. Wounded humans is also pretty bad. We're critically low on consumer goods also, at 14%. So if I could find something that would increase station energy, decrease station damage, and then like address some of those other issues, life systems perhaps, I think that would make me happy. So fire department will do some of that. And is fairly inexpensive. Do I actually have any components right now? I don't know where to look to see if I have any components. No idea. Cybernetics laboratory. Medical compartment. Again, this one sounded very promising, but if this is the before and after, I don't see the numbers changing. Main reactor. So this is not a supplementary, this is a fifth generation water reactor, large power generation facility, plus 10. Well, maybe what I'll do, let me check out this one that was up here, because it gives me plus 3 energy. Minus 1 damage, and then fewer wounded humans, which seems good. It doesn't do anything for our life support, though. Let me see if I can grab something with good life support. This residential area seems to be decent enough. Reactor support department. Emergency bunker. Protein farm. Good for the food supply. But like I said, I think we're okay with that. Air purification system. Here we go. So it is good for the energy, good for damage, and good for life systems. Let's go with this. It takes 40 components. Do we have enough? We do. It looks like we can do it again. So, then my question is, maybe instead of it being, these two columns being what's before and what's after, it'll be what is current and what will be added to it. Let's test that theory. If we click upgrade again, this should become plus 2, negative 2, and then plus 4 for life systems. So let's try it one more time. That is how it worked. Okay, so it is... Left column is current stats for this district versus what will be added to that. Okay. That is really good to know. And I think it's saying that I can't upgrade. Oh, here we go. Components. This is where our components meter is. Totally overlooked that earlier. Okay. Cool. So that is a 20. I don't I don't think I saw anything that would take 20 components to upgrade, so I think we're probably maxed out for now. So, I think we're ready to do a mission. Finally, we can do a mission. Which mission do I want to do? I don't particularly want to do the one with the RAM, because I think those are going to be absolutely terrible. A cave sounds pretty ominous to me, but who knows? This one looks like, so those are our resources that we're going to receive for this one. They're all ones, which is not great, I think. These are all twos. So we could go for either all ones or all twos. I am thinking that might be some subtle measure of difficulty. So maybe what I'll do is just pick this one. We just have the one type of enemy. We have, you know, we're getting some resources. It looks fine. I don't know. Let's do it. So we click on it. This loads up our sort of like mech loadout. So I'll select the first one. They should all be very similar. Let's see. One of them is different though. Which one is different? This one's different because it only has two Gatling guns, but one of them had a little bit extra reactor, like energy usage. I don't know. Ultimately, probably does not matter that much. I'm going to load it up if I can. That does not appear to be working. Ah, thank you. Thank you, Kyber. That does not work. What if I double click? Oh, double clicking probably just took it back to engineering. Indeed it did. Do I have enough? I do have enough engineers to send it back. But how do I load them up? This is to battle, the big red button. I would like to put my mechs in here. Perhaps I need to put pilots and mechs first. That would be logical. Okay, well, if that's the case, let's go by highest CBS test. Mr. Freeze here. You have great vitality. Not great reaction though. Stress resistance also seems not so good. Okay, let's sort by stress resistance. Your reaction is also not great. Your CBS is okay. Mr. Gregory here. Miss Ellen here has very, very bad vitality. And you have a terrible CBS test. Yeah, I'm looking back at Freeze. Stress resistance is not good. Reaction is also not good. Man. Mark, maybe? No. Alright, well, hey, I'm just gonna pick the very top one. Gregory. How do I load you up? Aha! I'll plug you in right there. Next we have... You are decent, Mr. Freeze. I don't think I want to take anyone with those bad stats. I'm going to go ahead and load up Donald into training, because he is very good all the way around, except for CBS test. So I think that will increase his CBS test rating. Ellen looks good except for her vitality, so maybe I'll drag her over into the hospital. Jennifer is absolutely terrible at vitality also. Stress resistance. Aren't I sorted by stress resistance? I'll be really scared if The highest we have left is 30%. Ugh. Okay, so stress resistance is not going to be a factor anymore if it's maxing out at 30%. So, let's plug in Mark. And... oof, vitality seems so bad, though. Reaction of 99, though, is so good. Oh, stress resistance 13 seems very bad, too. Okay, welcome to the team, Joe. Let's go to the mission. Let's click on the one we want. And click there. And now let's put Mr. Green as number one, as the captain. We'll load up maybe our shotgunner in last. I don't know if it matters after the first. Probably not. And let's battle. Okay, space will pause. So I paused it just to give myself a chance to kind of look around. Okay. Scanning. Doesn't look like these things do anything. I have the option to retreat if I click there. This is a... okay. It's telling me the key for the map. Resources, walls, enemies, bosses. These must be down here. So the green, it appears to be where I am. And then there are little, maybe walls in between. And there's some green spots down here, but I can't tell if those are resources or something else. No idea. Oh, something is blinking. Low FPS detected. GMS may be using an integrated video card instead of the usual one. Right, I saw this bug being talked about in a few different places. I can check this afterwards. So the frame rate really doesn't seem all that bad to me. And it's weird that it's just flashing on the screen now. That's pretty annoying. Interesting though. Okay, so this allows me to move. Well, I can cause them to move to a particular spot, I guess. I can shoot artillery. I wonder if there's ammo for the artillery also. Like, I know I get 4 shots, but I wonder if they refill automatically at the end of the mission, or if it's like 4 and that's it, and I have to spend something to get more. Focus fire seems like a great idea. Oh, nope, I'm gonna pause. Why can't I focus fire again? Oh, wait a minute. I see. So I can focus fire, and then I select on the map where I want that to be. Got it. This one is blocked out. I don't think there's any clicking I can do for any of these. I can just monitor the reactor temp and what they got going on, and then fingers crossed, hope that they don't die. We can select a different map color. I don't know. So I think they will head to their waypoint, like where their mission is, but I still don't know what the mission is. I don't actually have any information about what it will be, like what they're supposed to be doing. Or where they're going. Slow down. Oh, there are aliens spawning. The weapons seem to be pretty good. Certainly great spread. No problems taking them out. So, as I understand it, the way it's supposed to go is that... oh, it's this one. Okay, so the way I understand it is that the person you put into the first slot is the commander or the captain or something like that. And he will be the one, or he or she will be the one relaying to the team what they're supposed to be doing. And so it's very important that he be or she be in a good spot. Is this ammo, I wonder? Missile ammo and then machine gun ammo, perhaps. Perhaps, I don't know. Okay, but what we got here is a boss now. And from watching the video we saw earlier, this boss is gonna kind of rotate in a circle, and he's gonna shoot at things that get into his sort of area of effect within his circle that he's creating. So what we want to do is make sure that we are keeping it out of the keeping our guys out of that circle to keep them from getting hit by a big nasty laser beam. So I'm gonna make sure I have that the movement action selected. I'm going to command that they move sort of out of the line of sight of this big alien snake worm thing, and maybe see how that goes. Hey, 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 you're not listening to me. They are so not listening to me. Over here, guys. This is not going well. That did not work at all. I don't know why though. I have new position clicked. I tried both the left click and right clicking. Neither of them did anything as far as I could tell. I'm trying to move them down here. And they are not listening at all. Weird. It's just a test message for beta. Oh, the FPS thing is? Okay. What if I do this? I don't think it would make sense for this to work, but let's try this. No. Actions. New position. Please move down here. Okay, now they're listening to me. Hey guy, you gotta get out of there. You're gonna die if you don't move. Number two, Mark. Mark.
Slow down.
Mark is basically just gonna die because he is stuck, I guess. Come on, guys, shoot the worm. Free your buddy. Oh man. His mech is taking so much damage. You can tell over here, you can see it's these little bars, I guess, represent the damage that we've received in this mech so far. And notice the other ones are all perfect so far. This one is doing very poor. And he's screaming, ah! Which makes sense. Incorrect position.
New position. Continue.
Okay. It looks like he's trying to move but can't, probably because the worm mech is destroyed. Yeah, I figured. All right, now I need to keep them. Why is it saying incorrect
New
position?
position.
Is it off the map or something, maybe? I don't think so. Oh, hey, we killed the worm. Cool. Okay. Well, I think I saw something on the map over here. Resource crate thing, if I remember the yeah, right here. Let's collect that. Oh, and there's another one. So that is what those little green dots are then. Cool. Well, in that case, let's grab the others. Hey, Iron. How are you doing tonight? Thanks for checking out my YouTube stream. We're playing a Mech Engineer. We are sort of past the engineering state of this little part of the game and really focused on now the auto battler portion. Okay. Are we done? I assume that they'll go to the exit point. Maybe I can't assume that, though.
Continue mission.
Okay. Oh, I left-click to cancel my order, which will cause them to continue the mission. Okay, got it. Okay. So that's a little backwards from how the rest of the game worked, where you left click on something to select it and then you right click to cancel your selection. It seems like in the auto battler you are doing the opposite of that, where you right click to cause something to happen and then you cancel with left click. Battle group. Okay, so this is the mission completion. We killed 682 alien bugs. We unfortunately lost a pilot, or maybe we didn't lose a pilot. Mark here, I thought Mark was going to be dead, but he looks like he just has a damaged mech. Maybe he was able to get out or something. But number of overheating, 0. That's great. Total time for disobeying orders, 127. I'm curious about Mark here. Total time for disobeying orders is 27.3. Now, there was speculation in the comments of Splattercat's video that the majority of the total time disobeying orders was not a indication of their sanity, but more a indication of, like, they were stuck by environmental effects, like the tornado or something. And Mark here seemed to be stuck by the worm, the boss, the whole time that he was there. So maybe that's true. Maybe total time disobeying orders wasn't an intentional thing due to stress. It was like he was unable to obey. Iron Brigade is playing some golf with friends. Very cool. That must be what Cater is doing also. That sounds like fun. Interesting. How are the other ones? There's a little bit of time disobeying on the other ones as well. Average reactor temperature is very low. Amount of time spent ammo. Amount of time spent ammo? Does that mean spent reloading ammo? I'm not sure. I guess I didn't pay close enough attention to see if it was like reloading, like they weren't firing the whole time or something. But okay, cool. Let's continue. So we have expanded our area of control a tiny bit. That is a selected cell, I guess, is where we are here now. So we're trying to find a city, right? I think I saw a city maybe down this way. I do not want rams. Although, you know, rams actually may not be terrible for me because of the way that my mechs are set up. But anyway, we have a day. Oh, look. Mark is gone. I wonder if he went into the hospital or if he's actually dead. Mark does not appear to be here. I would have expected to see on the previous, like, the end of mission report, if Mark was dead, that it would have, you know, kind of like the message here for the mech. It says damaged. I would have expected to see, like, an X or, like, a deceased or, you know, KIA or something like that. Maybe even just this flag where it says exhausted, having it say, like, killed in action or something like that. Okay, but we don't have enough mechs or pilots to do another mission on this day, so I think we need to skip to the next day. And it looks like we have things on the calendar here that are happening tomorrow and the next day, but I don't know what. I think this is our tech. I think it said 2 days for the tech. No idea what's happening on Tuesdays that involve people. I have no idea. But anyway, let's go ahead and skip to the next day. Okay. Maybe this is telling us that we did not produce anything yet. We have queued them up, but we have not created them. I'm not sure. It looks like we have used more medlight than we produced from that mission. We spent more components than we've produced, which makes sense. We have fewer wounded humans, which seems like a good thing. But it's red, so maybe it's not. Our life support system appears to be the same. Our efficiency has dropped slightly. Although, our efficiency has dropped slightly, but it was 100% before, and now it's 50%. That seems odd. Now, I don't know how to make this indicator, this pop-up thing go away. Nope, I'm clicking something under it now. Yeah, so I have no idea how to interact with this thing, this pop-up here. It appears to be on top of everything. Like, I can select the stuff that's under it, as you see here. But it doesn't seem to be letting me interact with this. Oh, I just moved something out of the hangar. Oh, well. And if I change the section that I'm in, it's not making a difference. It's not doing anything differently. Here's our research screen, but we're already queued up on research. I don't think we'll have enough to do anything with that today. Not until it's done tomorrow. This is bizarre. I can't seem to make this little window dialogue go away. Oh, wait. Okay, that's odd. See, I would expect to see some sort of a button, something that would show like a, you know, up, exit, you know, something to show that I need to like swing it up or something, but I see I can. Okay. Good to know. Mechs here, the shadow is damaged. Okay, so maybe what we'll do for the shadow then, instead of fixing it, is unload the weapons and the components, like strip it essentially, so that we can reuse these components elsewhere instead of fixing it, since we have another two mech chassis. Okay. So now let's toss the damaged mech back. Oh, nope, it still has the reactor. Okay, there we go. Alright, now let's grab a steel. Let's throw in the reactor and everything else. We'll give it a missile and a Gatling gun, a cockpit. We'll give it four motors, and we'll give it all ammo modules. Because the battery module won't help us, I don't believe. There's nothing we can do with that. Evasion module, I don't know if that would have helped our dude that died from the worm, but I kind of don't doubt it. Or I don't think it would help at all. Not sure. I think I'll just be okay with this. Let's send this one over to the hangar. Can we build anything? Looks like no. It's all locked in. Don't think there's anything I can do with that. I can't do anything with research. So I think we're back now to going on another mission. Let's see if any of our pilots are feeling better now. Let's pull our folks out of the hospital and out of training. Let's sort by stress resistance again. Stress resistance. Oh, yeah, see, again, Gregory is just excellent and has good relation, though I don't know what that means. So I'll bring you back in as a captain because you're doing swell. What about you? Vitality has improved. Ellen's vitality, I think, was like 8 before, and now it's 19, which seems really swell. So, I don't know how much that matters, the vitality. But the other stats are all pretty good, so I'm gonna go with it. We'll see. It could be a mistake. This is how you learn. Donald, CBS test is so poor on Donald. I'm gonna throw you back into training. Jennifer has terrible reaction time. Vitality has gotten better, but I think I'm gonna throw her back into the hospital a little bit more, give her better vitality. Freeze, sure. I'll throw you back in the cockpit. And then Joe. Yep. Okay, and then that leaves Barbara here, who has fine vitality, but not great rest. I think I'm gonna throw Zed into the hospital to help with the things that he lacks, the vitality and stress. Okay, so we have a new squad. Let's go to the mission screen and see if we can pick another one. Energy attacks from this one. And again, I'm looking for a city if I can. Let's do this one. Let's throw our team in and let's battle. All right, new mission. They are on their way. I still don't know what their mission is, but they know what they're doing. Reactor temps all seem good. I don't see the enemy yet, but they must. No enemy base. Oh, yeah, here's a resource container. Thank you for trying to grab that first. I appreciate that. Where are those missiles coming from? Hey. Oh. Are you gonna... You need to get this one, too. Are you gonna collect it? Yeah, good job. Go ahead and... Yeah, continue. Very good. It looks like there's some more to the south, though. We'll see what they do on their own before I force them to go down there. I'm guessing it's another boss fight, but I actually have no idea what we're going to be fighting. Oh, stop. Nope, get out of there, get out of the beam. Great. Oh, no, get out of the beam. Come on. Okay. Phew. Sorry, Joe. Oh, looks like they all took some damage, but, wow. Can I go here now? You can now go engage the worm. In fact, go ahead and stay to the side of the worm. Go a little bit faster, please. Please go faster. Looks like we're doing decent damage, at least. Come on. Come on. Keep moving. Okay. It's not so bad. Oh, we got it. Okay, great. Oh, it's going to continue to be, but I don't want it to leave yet. I want it to go... see if I can grab those resources. Incorrect position. I wonder why. Is that like invalid terrain or something? Kyber Cracker, I see you say choose perks. Is that back on the squad, the pilot screen? I need to choose what perks? Maybe I misunderstood earlier and I saw all the perks and thought, oh wow, they have so many perks, but maybe it's like they have the option and I have to pick which one that they get. Okay, can you get to this one? It looks like that terrain is inaccessible, but maybe if I get close enough, you'll be able to figure it out. Can you do it? Yeah, you can do it. Very good. Hey, Anne, welcome. It seems a little weird, like our missiles are coming in from off screen sometimes. I kind of wish there was a way to manually choose how quickly things are going. Because I've seen it appear on the screen before where it's like 2x speed or something. Why is it doing that? That sound. I have no idea why that sound was playing. That was the sound of like completing a mission or completing a goal or something, right? Like that's the sound that happens when we killed the boss and when we picked up the crates and things like that. But we were just walking that time. Maybe, like, I don't see any more bugs. Maybe we killed all the bad guys and that's a mission objective in and of itself. Couldn't say. We took some damage, but it looks like it was all repaired. It was just the superficial, just armor damage. Looks like our folks did pretty well. I don't know how to tell that, though. You know, I don't know how to tell if they took any damage. Okay, let's go back to the pilot screen. And so these are the perks. So I guess I have to pick one. Gives 15% invasion, increases accuracy by 30, and plus one critical chance. Can repair allied mechs with a drone. The drone is in use all the time. Interesting. That seems like it would be really positive. Speeds up your overheating recovery by 150%, and overheating does no damage. That also sounds potentially really good. Chance to return destroyed mech increased to 75%, and also returns a pilot. Oh. I don't know how you get new pilots, so that seems like it could be the best so far. Once every 3 seconds with a 15% chance, taunts all enemies for 3 seconds. Speed of mechs is increased by 15% if this pilot is the commander. Oh, okay. The reload speed of all mechs is increased by 25% if this pilot's the commander. Or the speed of the drones repairing is increased by 50% if this pilot is the commander. Well, I mean, your reaction time is terrible. 17 does not give me much confidence in you. I think what I'll do is not pick this yet, but try to remember to pick it for our team later. Yeah, I see. Okay. So like, Freeze, I think, has it. Yep. Is it the same ones? Yes, it does appear to be the same one. So, chance to return destroyed mech increased to 75% and also returns a pilot. Now, my question for the game would be if this is just for this pilot, like, does it make, in the event that this pilot or this mech is destroyed, it will increase the chance to recover it by 75% and this pilot will be recovered? Or if this is for all mechs, like, if I bring this pilot on a mission, will it make all of the mechs better or just this one? I have the same question for the drone, though it looks like it does say can repair allied mechs. So I think that does mean everyone. I don't care as much about taunting. Speed of all mechs is increased by 15% if it's the commander. I mean, I do like the idea of having a commander that's boosting everyone, but I think Gregory would be the person I'd want. Oh, they have relations to each other? Interesting. So if I'm looking, like, let's say looking at Freeze and I see, well, I'm on him and it says relation 53, but if I hover over Joe and Ellen and people, it's like relation 70. But then what do those numbers mean on the right side? It says 48. So if I bring Helen over, or not Helen, but Ellen over. Ah, okay, so it is comparing the stats of this pilot versus the stats for the other pilot, so you can see how they stack up against each other. Oh, so that's a great way to help find which pilots are better than others. Okay. Okay, good to know. Let's just pull everyone back. I still think Gregory is just really solid. It's too bad that Gregory doesn't have any perks for... Oh, wait! Gregory does have perks for being commander. The speed of all drones, no. Reload speed of all mechs is increased. I mean, I haven't seen them reload yet, so I'm not 100% sure how valuable that is. The speed of all mechs is increased. That seems like it could be really valuable if I'm commanding them. Hey, Buggy, welcome back. I am having fun with this game. Yeah, there's a lot of, like, trying to figure out exactly what everything does and, like, the right way to configure things, but the last two missions have been mostly successful, except for the one pilot that died. So, yeah. I think it's good. I'm really enjoying it. And I mentioned this at the beginning, but it's been a couple hours now. So, just as a reminder to everyone, this is Mech Engineer. I'm going to be doing other live streams on this coming up. I have another one scheduled for a week from today, 9 p.m. Central Time. It'll be on Friday. It'll be just a Let's Play. So obviously it'll be just like this one, except, you know, obviously it's not my first look. So it'll just be a regular Let's Play. We'll go through, probably continue on with this storyline because I haven't died yet, or at least been totally wiped out yet. But also, if you have any questions or comments or other things like that, throw it in the chat. Throw it in the comments if you're watching this later. And let me know what questions you have or what things you'd like to see in a future video, because I think I could probably, once I read the book, once I go through and play a little bit longer, I could create a tutorial video or something and try to give a primer of, like, everything you need to know to get started in Mech Engineer. And I think that would be really, really good for helping some people get started and kind of get off the ground. Okay, I'm just going to pick something. I'm going to say the speed of all mechs is increased by 15% if he's the commander. And he is the commander. He's the one I've been going with. So that will speed up all the mechs whenever he's running. Knowing that he is the commander, I maybe won't choose that perk for some of the other people. So maybe like, hey, Freeze, why don't we do... I really do like increasing accuracy. But repairing allied mechs seems really good too. What is your CBS is so good, 91, which is like your, I forget what it stands for, but it's like how good you are at using the mech under various conditions. Your reaction isn't great, but I think I'm gonna give you the damage one. Increase accuracy by 30%. Cool. Dom, we haven't used Dom because the Dom's stress resistance is very poor. So I think that's all that I'll do for those now. I think I'm ready to end the day. Calendar? Yeah, next day. Okay, so we accumulated a lot more resources this turn, which is excellent. Our food supply has went down, which is expected. We do have fewer wounded humans, and our efficiency has dropped a little bit more. Okay, those all seem fine. We do have science team back. We have completed our research for reinforced frame. What else is left? Armor. Develop additional armor technology. Only 25 staff for that one. That's really good. New mech. Yes. I definitely want a new mech. So let's go ahead and select that. Absolutely. There we go. We still have 66 science team left. So let's go ahead and assign them to the armor. Better armor is going to keep us alive longer. Components. Have we created any components? I don't think so. Yeah, I don't think so. If I go to... If I go to here, I have 21 components. Yeah, I don't have enough components to actually upgrade anything. Although it does say 2. Can I upgrade something? What if I go to the emergency bunker? No. Station energy? No. I want to do... Oh, this will increase the number of components I have by 2%. I mean, components are good, so... Sure? Yeah, I don't have enough components for that. Okay. That's what I suspected. Okay. Well, that is all that we got for that. We have our mechs, which are repaired, I think. We have our pilots, which should be good to go again. I think we're ready for our third mission, but unfortunately, it's getting pretty late for me. It is time for me to call it a night and head off to bed, I think. So, just want to thank you all for attending the stream tonight, watching me play... Kind of get a first look at Mech Engineer. It was a lot of fun. I really enjoyed it. If you enjoyed what you saw, I would definitely recommend checking out this game on Steam. You can go down in the doobly-doo in the description below the video and click the link to go over to Steam. There is a demo, but like I said earlier in the stream, the demo is a little bit out of date, so there's going to be more bugs there, and it's also apparently a little bit harder because it's missing some stuff or things are configured in a different sort of way. So... check out the demo if you're interested, but just know it might be not the experience that you're going to get if you actually buy the game. And like I said before, also, the developer who is right here in the chat with us, Kyber Krecker, is very, very active in the community that he's creating. And also, well, also putting out a lot of updates. There'll be a new update next week for the full game. That's not the beta. And... yeah, it's exciting to see something like this come along in early access and actually get attention from the developers and, you know, come through this pathway. I think the game is really exciting. It is definitely a different sort of game. It's not high action, anything like that, but there's lots of strategy that I'm really digging. So again, consider checking it out. If you did like this, insert obligatory YouTube shilling thing here where, subscribing really does help. It lets you get notified if I create more videos. Liking also is apparently a thing that will help with the YouTube algorithm. So if you enjoyed the video, click the like button. And then if you want to get notified about future streams that are coming through, like I said, there's one coming up on Friday. There'll probably be one next Friday after that as well. And you can click the bell icon next to the subscribe button to get notified whenever new videos get posted. I will probably be doing other things this week as well. So I'll be doing most likely a West of Loathing Part 3 coming up on Saturday. Oh, no, I'm sorry, Sunday. So in 2 days. And what else? Yeah, and if you enjoyed the game, just again, stick around the community, continue watching the videos. I will be doing a giveaway, I believe, in a few streams from now, where I will raffle off or give away basically a key to the game. That's my intention. So if that's interesting to you, stick around, keep watching the streams, and maybe you'll win a copy of the game yourself. But yeah, I think that's everything. Thank you everyone again for attending the stream. Thank you, Kyber Krecker, for attending and giving me some support, and Kay and everyone else in the stream as well. It's great to see you all tonight. And hope to see you next week too. I hope you have a good evening, good weekend, and happy holidays. I'll see you next time. Bye-bye.